Thanks for joining us here on the web. Manchester police have identified a suspect in the armed robbery of the subway on Elm Street. Police say last night, 40-year-old Timothy Potter held up the store at gunpoint, also robbing two customers. They say he should be considered armed and dangerous. Ray Brewer has the story from Manchester.
This is a very dangerous individual.
Timothy Potter is currently wanted for parole and probation violations, but Manchester police say you can add armed robbery to that. Police say this surveillance video shows Potter committing the robbery of Subway on Elm Street. Police say last night, around 8:45, Potter entered the store and ordered a sandwich. Then, as the clerk began to ring him up, he pulled out a gun.
I'm putting a gun in the face of clerk, grabbing her in the back room, forcing her to the front, and then at gunpoint robbing two customers on his way out, taking items from them. It's an extremely violent crime.
Police say that after robbing the men, Potter fled east across Elm Street. Police are stressing if you see Potter, don't approach him. Instead, call police.
He's an extremely volatile, dangerous individual. We do know he's armed from the incident from last night.
This was the third armed robbery in Manchester in the past 2 days. Monday night, two gas stations were hit, but police think someone else was responsible for those.
We don't believe the first two are connected to this third one.
However, police say that they are worried about what seems to be a recent trend in robberies.
The violent nature of these past three robberies have us concerned. We are going all out with our investigative efforts to get these people, to get them arrested, and to get the guns that they're possessing off the streets.
Police say it's important not to confront an armed robber. Instead, they recommend complying with the demands, but pay attention to details. Keep in mind your safety is what's most important. A police officer responding to a medical call needed help of his own this morning. Police say Windham officer Brian Landry went through the intersection of Route 111 and North Lowell Road with his lights on when a woman driving west hit his cruiser. The impact pushed the cruiser into a pole. Landry went to the hospital. He was not seriously hurt. The woman walked away from the crash. Well, for the second year in a row, House lawmakers in Concord passed a right-to-work bill. It would allow public workers to choose whether to join a union and pay its dues. The bill passed the House this morning by a simple majority, leaving it vulnerable to a veto by Governor Lynch. The governor vetoed an identical bill last year. Voters in dozens of Granite State communities cast their ballots in town meetings yesterday with several noteworthy results. In Hampstead, voters turned down a $1.5 million 10-year bond to build a new police station, the fourth attempt to get it built. In Pelham, voters approved a new firehouse that will cost $4 million to construct. And in Bedford, after decades of overseeing the town's elections, Rick Bullock lost his bid for re-election. In a nearly 2-to-1 margin, Bedford voters selected Brian Shaughnessy to the post. Bullock started as assistant town moderator in 1973. To see the town meeting results in your community, head to our website, WMUR.com. A few days early, but everyone was sporting their St. Paddy's Day best this morning at the Radisson in Manchester. For the past 12 years, former Mayor Bob Baines has hosted a Blarney breakfast. It's a chance for politicians to poke a little fun at one another and for everyone to take in a little Irish entertainment. The breakfast also serves as a fundraiser for an organization dedicated to helping refugees in Manchester, the Special Olympics, and the American Red Cross. Starting tonight at 5, words of warning for seniors who have surgery. A new study finds that some painkillers prescribed afterward may lead to long-term use. The risks that can create for some patients. That does it for us here on the web. We wish you a great afternoon.